Hey, I'm back to be more of a chatty Cathy. I seem to have gotten more comfortable talking, so here we go. Good old seaweed, seaweed kelp, aka foliar feed. I'm not good with fertilizers. I have never fertilized my orchids because I have failed miserably. So, yeah. But go check out Orchids for Dummies channel. He is so good and he really breaks everything down. I have here the Grow More Seaweed Extract Foliar Feed, Root Dip, Soil Drench, and here I will mix some rainwater and seaweed extract in my little spray bottle. I don't like to fill too much because it gets really clumpy. I've broken. Okay, here we go. It seems like a smaller spray bottle tube is better. The other two were larger than this one. Alright, getting started. I have a disposable plastic dropper. I got a bag from Amazon. I will link below my video of Orchid Supplies Amazon haul. I also linked those items in that video. I poked a hole for easy access, no pun intended. I drew up about 15 milliliters. I think it's 15. Either way, the 15 mark. Pretty simple. Drop some water in the bottle. Like I said, not too much. If it sits too long, it gets clumpy and
gonna have a bad time.
Now, I use this foliar feed to gently spritz down the leaves, and when I say gently, I mean gently. You can get these brown spots on the leaves, you know, from just the moisture or water sitting on the leaves. I got this trick from Darrell and from Orchids for Dummies, and he said his leaves had that situation. So you gotta be careful or
you're gonna have a bad time.
I love that clip. Anyways, that wraps that up. I figured I'd give you a sneak peek of my next video for those that stuck around. This is my waterfall orchid. Too many leaves fell off. I don't even want to say. I'm sure too much energy was being put into that spike because, and I have cinnamon all over the base of it because it was starting to turn black. Sad face. This cakey mother is not doing well. She started growing a new keiki. I have been debating really hard about separating the new, the old one. And fun fact, when an orchid is dying or thinking about dying, they will clone themselves for survival. Seedlings is a whole other video and topic for another day. So the roots turned real grungy all of a sudden, but I'm not surprised. I didn't expect it to go on this long, especially with no roots. There has been absolutely no new leaf growth, no new root growth. It's focused on these keikis, trying to pass on a legacy. But, you know, coulda, woulda, shoulda with the way I handled the roots one of the leaves are yellowing, which is not good at all. The leaves are pretty limp and sad. I just need to accept that she's not gonna make it. She's just not. But I even hung on to this orchid that had crown rot, and I didn't really know what all the ailments were. Like, I really was just figuring everything out. And everybody in the Facebook group was like, oh, good luck, hope everything's okay. And I think everybody knew it was gonna die, and they're so nice. Okay, one last look on of the keikis. Yeah, aren't they cute? Yeah, okay. I'll see you guys. Well, I'll talk to you guys later. Thank you.